staged, tactically faultless rally, Ireland's folk hero of the 70s returns to take his third Circuit of Ireland victory, winning by a staggering 22-minute margin. With Ronan Morgan co-driving, Billy Coleman, almost alone among the top seeds, has survived a rally of devastating attrition to triumph. And all Ireland celebrates with him.
So, after the first two rounds of this year's championship, these are over the...
And welcome back to Word of Sport. Well, last week, the sixth round of the World Rally Championship, the Rothmans Acropolis Rally, took place in Greece. It was a grueling, high-speed, four-day battle over the hot, dusty and boulder-strewn byroads of central and southern Greece. The Acropolis Rally is the roughest in the World Championship, but what made it highly significant this year was that if Audi could win the event in resounding style with their four-wheel drive Quattros, keeping their principal opponents Lancia out of the top places, they would virtually assure themselves of the 1984 manufacturer's title. For Lancia, then, this was effectively the last chance to keep their title hopes alive. Their number one driver, Marco Alén, led the drivers' championship with 48 points. Hannu Mikkola was 4 points behind in second place, and Stig Blomqvist, tipped by many to be this year's world champion, was third with 43 points. As the map shows, the rally started in Athens, headed north via Thebe, Itaia and Lamia for an overnight halt at Kalambaka, and then back again southwards to Athens. The final leg was an anti-clockwise loop in the Peloponnese Peninsula, going as far south as Sparta, with the cars returning by ferry boat from Poros for the finish in Athens. And it's in the sun-drenched capital that our report starts.
As the cars line up before the start, additional excitement is expected to be provided by Ari Vatanen's new Peugeot, making its second World Series appearance. Last year's winner, Walter Röhrl, is only too aware of the opposition.
So, Walter, are you going to repeat your victory of last year here this year?
Anyway, I would like to try it, of course. But I think it's a little bit more difficult in two ways. First of all, I'm using a complete new car, which is first gravel rally for our short quattro. And second, we have a lot of very good cars starting here. But anyway, my style of driving will be just to save the car, to go slowly, like I have done always when I was winning here. And maybe it works.
Do you think you're going to dominate this rally like you did the Corsica with this new car?
Well, that's very kind of you to suggest. But yes, I mean, to be honest about it, I mean, we do have a good chance, but we are not the only one with a good chance. So, but I think if I'm sensible not to go too fast in wrong places, I mean the rough places, I think we should be able to match the speed of Audis and Lancias.
I hope you know I take in here in a good result. Winning or top three, that's the minimum I want here. But you know, in Greece, this year is very, very rough rally, and you never know. But I hope I take in good result here. That's important.
So you're not going to go flat out for a win then?
No, it's difficult. You know, in here you go in flat out, in that's gravel, and road is so rough this year. You know, in heavy rain here in winter time, and now it's very, very bad in road. I never see increase in rough road like in this year. I never see.
Röhrl's 400 horsepower short wheelbase Audi Quattro leads the field away from the start. He's followed by Marco Alén, the Lancia team leader, in his supercharged rally. In the prevailing hot and dry conditions, dust is obviously going to present severe visibility problems. And so by being number one on the road, Röhrl has a priceless advantage. This latest Quattro derivative has a hastily redesigned oil cooling system following problems in Corsica, but already it's running at a dangerously high temperature. With a portion of his car's underbody protection flapping loose, World Championship leader Marco Alén is already aware that his latest tyres, developed specially for this event, are proving exceptionally prone to punctures. Quietly confident before the start, Ari Vatanen is playing himself in gently with a new four-wheel drive Peugeot 205. The impressive machine, a sensation on the all-tarmac Tour de Corse, is making its World Championship debut on gravel roads. With a restricted program of rallies this year, Michel Mouton has been able to recapture all the fire and determination that marked her superb season in 1982. Driving the number two short wheelbase Audi, she sets fastest time on Special Stage 2. As usual in Greece, Finnish driver Timo Salonen leads the massed ranks of the Nissan Challenge in his conventional 270 horsepower 240 RS. Comprehensively outclassed, Salonen's car has already required a new gearbox. Principal puncture sufferer in the Lancia team is the Italian Attilio Bettega, who has yet to get a stage time among the top five. Like Michel Mouton, Haru Mikkola's performances seem to be benefiting from a restricted 1984 program. Trying very hard here, he's fastest on two of the opening four tests. Backing up Salonen in the Nissan A-Team is safari specialist Shekhar Mehta, co-driven by his wife Yvonne. An undoubted rally star in the making is the young Italian Mickey Biasion, who after a fine second place on the Tour de Corse is now fighting back after a puncture on the opening special stage. But the fight for the lead lies between Mikkola and this man, Stig Blomqvist, who after 60 flat-out stage miles is just 3 seconds ahead, despite a first stage puncture. And most spectacular over the jumps of special stage four is Lancia's young showman, Henry Toivonen, making his second appearance at a Lancia rally after a disastrous debut in Portugal. American John Buffum's Acropolis debut is truly a multinational effort. His German Audi Quattro is British prepared and is navigated by Toivonen's former co-driver, Irishman Fred Gallagher. 1 mile from the finish of the 26-mile 10th special stage, and Blomqvist has established himself in a 43-second lead ahead of Mikkola, who is still chasing hard. The A2 old-style Quattros holding the advantage over their more powerful intended replacements. Up into third place is Vatanen's remarkable turbocharged Peugeot, and having dropped to a lowly 14th place as a result of an early puncture, Roral's characteristically brilliant performance has already dragged him back to fourth. Languishing deep in serious tyre trouble, the Lancias present no threat whatsoever to the Audis, and already all the Italians can hope is for trouble to hit the German camp. Driving steadily but nevertheless maintaining sixth place, Frenchman Jean-Pierre Nicolas is Peugeot's reliable anchorman. After stopping to change a puncture and with a badly slipping clutch, Michel Mouton has slid down to eighth, just ahead of the two Italian drivers, Biasion and Bettega. But as the cars head north in the intense afternoon heat and the ever-worsening dust, a dramatic turn of fortune lies in store with the approach of darkness. Walter Röhrl is the new leader by a scant 2 seconds as the cars arrive at Kalambaka. But despite his situation, he's a most unhappy man.
Walter, what's the problem? What's up?
The problem is it's in every stage the same. After 8 kilometers, my oil temperature is 130 and I have to go down to 5,000 revs. I have to wait for 3-4 kilometers that it's coming down. Then I go again 3 kilometers fast, 2 kilometers slow, 3 fast. I paid minutes for minutes coming here.
But it seems that he's not alone in his frustration. His Audi teammates are far from happy, hampered as they've been by choking dust and failing electrics.
We think the alternator is not charging properly. So we are going to change that tomorrow after the two first stages when we have a little bit more time.
How is it affecting you on that last stage then? What was happening?
The engine is not running clean. Misfiring all the time.
Yeah, and off. Yeah.
Because then it stops completely, then it goes again.
We will test it now.
Team manager Roland Goodput gets the facts of the situation from Mikkola.
Hello.
But the Finn is reluctant to divulge any further information. Completing the unhappiness among the Audi team is the news that Michel Mouton has retired with a blown engine. And to compound the chaos and confusion reigning at the Kalambaka service point, Blomqvist, now down in fourth place, arrives no less distressed. Co-driver Bjorn Cederberg mysteriously conjures up the material answer to his driver's prayers. But where it came from, nobody knows. Meanwhile, the mechanics seem more concerned with changing the tyres. There'll be no replacement alternator tonight.
This is no problem.
Tomorrow leave machine in.
What? Tomorrow?
Yes.
Where?
But we have no time. 20 minutes for leave machine.
How much time do you have?
17.
17, 17 minutes.
17 minutes now.
Yeah. Okay.
See what's gone wrong?
No, the alternator is kaput.
You are a fighting lot.
Oh dear. How's that affected your time on our stage?
Nah, it's still going, but it's not so funny.
What are you doing? This is not important.
Mr. Philip.
Even by morning, the drama is far from over. Rorol's distributor fails, and Vatanen inherits the lead as the cars wind south towards Athens through this parched, remote land. Is equally short-lived, the Peugeot suffering a broken oil pump drive and a turbocharger failure, all of which hands a comfortable two-minute lead back to Blomqvist. Mikkola is now second. And Rorol, having lost 7.5 minutes, is driving brilliantly, clawing his way back from sixth to third place. Alain is now the leading Lancia driver in fifth place, following Toivonen's second successive accident in consecutive outings for the Italians. Biasion in the tow-tip car is sixth. Following Vatanen's retirement after a grand battle with Nicolas Audi, Nicola in the sole surviving Peugeot is seventh, while Berger is still struggling with punctures in eighth place as the cars arrive back in Athens at midnight for an 18-hour respite. In the Peloponnese on the final morning. At last, Audi team orders are working in Blomqvist's favour, and his 1 minute 40 second lead is secure. Mikkola is an equally secure second. In fourth place, 9 minutes behind the leader, Alain is fortunate to profit from third place man Rorol's engine failure, just two special stages from the finish. Bettiger's Lancia struggles home fourth. A splendid effort from Buffum's multinational entry gives him fifth place. In the shadow of the Acropolis itself, of where it all began 4 days ago, Stig Blomqvist and Bjorn Cederberg return in triumph after 1,400 miles, including some of the roughest special stages in Europe. A well-deserved victory puts Stig back on course for the World Championship this year, and Audi are all but assured of the manufacturer's series. In 1984, the Germans seem set to carry all before them.
Well, it'll keep the dust down, that champagne, won't it? There, after six rounds, is the leaderboard. Stig Blomqvist, they say he's the greatest rally driver in the world, when he leads the World Championship now with six championships. The rally started in Glasgow last...